first part of your English grammar of high school. That is class. Dear students, this will take a number of days in finishing, and you must be aware that you will all have to clear all the points that will be related from the class, because a number of obstacles you will face in understanding. Okay, so we are going to make it easy, and don't need to be worry about this class. That will look very limited if you will have cleared all the points easily, all the points with concentration. Then definitely, my dear students, I am damn sure that you will make it clear, right? So without making a delay, let's have a start of the topic. So first of all, as it is written, as you can see, the title is given as class. So first of all, we will discuss about the title. What the title class suggests us? It suggests that a group of words that is exactly the part of a sentence and whose meaning is clear, that will be your class, right? How you can say, sometimes a statement is written like where he goes, where he goes, I know, I know. Where he goes, I know. Or I know where he lives. So my dear students, I have written two different statements in which you have to identify the class. So now you can see that I know where he lives is a sentence, a complete sentence, and where he goes, I know, is also a complete sentence. Okay, so now if we will just separate the parts of this sentence, like I know is being separated from he lives, where he lives, or here where he goes is being separated from this I know. So I know is, you are very well aware that I know is a complete sentence if it is written in anywhere, and this is all about present indefinite tense example. It can be said that it is a example of past indefinite tense, present indefinite tense, and he lives is also is a part of present indefinite tense. So my dear students, basically we can say that I know where he lives is a sentence, but the meaning of this group of words like I know is clear. So what it will be? It will be considered as a class. Where he lives, the meaning of this one is also clear, then it will be also a class. So that's all about class. Now, what is the meaning? What will be the definition? Definition will be an arrangement of words, an arrangement of words in a sentence. Only for part. It will be only a part. That arrangement will be clause. Okay. So this is the definition of my dear student for clause. And as example, you can write it. Where he goes, I know where he goes, that will be class. Okay, my dear student. Now just note it down. Further, we are going to classify our noun into different kinds of categories. According to some literary person, this grammar has been classified basically in two categories. The first one was that was considered as the non-finite class only, and the second one was the finite class. According to your ancient grammar, only finite grammar was, finite classes was taught, but after awareness of non-finite verbs, we are continuously reading non-finite clauses. So my dear students, we will look after our classes into different aspects, but first today we are going to classify our clauses according to their place, according to their function, what they do in two categories. Only in two categories these clauses are classified. So what will be the kinds of class? Kinds of class. So basically there are two kinds of noun. The first one was dependent and the second one will be independent. Independent. These dependent class be called as dependent or subordinate. Independent class. Okay. My dear students, let's have a start of making the classification, understanding the classification of noun or pronoun. Classification of class. Okay, my dear students. So let's have a start of that. Okay. What will be the starting point for this? Main clause. First of all, we will look after main clause. What a main clause is? Dear students, main clause doesn't require, main clause doesn't require any group of words for its meaning. It can stand alone. Clause dependent plant, it needs a few group of words for its meaning. It can't stand alone. Okay? So, my dear students, these are the grounds of the classification of this main class or dependent class or subordinate class. Okay? That means this main class or the principal class, you can also say, that will be also independent class that doesn't require, that doesn't need any group of words for the clarification of its meaning. That means if it will be presented within a sentence, the whole meaning of the sentence will be clear. But some parts of sentence needs a support, and support for what? For the clarification of its meaning, that will be dependent clause. You can also call it as a subordinate clause, by this way. Right? So now let's have an example for this. Only single example will be enough for the clarification of all of them. Okay? So what I, where I was going, I was going there when I saw him. I was going there when I saw him. Right. These two are the basic classes. You are very well aware with this. And why it will be class? Because its meaning has been clear. But now the point is, which class it would be? Which class? Okay. So that's very easy to understand it. I was going, that's the principal word, I was going. And after that, you will ask what? After that, you will ask, when I will make a statement that I was going, then your question will be what? That means, what will be the substitute? What will be the substitute? Right? That will be, so first of all, it will be the principal one, because it can stand alone. It will be the principal class, and this one will be subordinate. Okay, so here you can see in this statement, I was going can stand alone, but I saw him cannot stand alone. It needs a substitute for the clarification of its meaning. That's all about this class, my dear students. Further, what we can classify? Further, we can classify this dependent clause also, that means this subordinate class, in three broad categories, that will be noun clause, adjective clause, and adverbial clause. So, my dear students, up to the time, just note it at your notebook. Today we have covered the definition of class and its two of the classification, that the biggest classification are the main and subordinate class. My dear students, from tomorrow we start learning about the classification of kinds, classification of subordinate class, my dear students. Up to the time, thank you. Have a nice day.